Hi, welcome to Team Orthodontics. I'm Dr. Daniluk, or Dr. D as most people call me. I want you to know that today's visit is all about you. In just a few minutes, I'll come in to meet with you and we'll get a chance to spend some time together. I'll do a thorough but easy exam on your teeth and jaws. And we'll talk about your situation, what your goals are, when's the best time to start treatment, and the different ways we can work together to meet those goals. But first, there are a few important things we need to cover. And here's Nikki to tell us more. Hi, Nikki.
Thanks, Dr. D. You know, as you begin orthodontic treatment, it's important to understand a few things, like what is a healthy bite, where you might need some help, and what to expect on your first visit. The first thing you should know about orthodontic treatment is that it's not all about your teeth. Just as important, if not more important, is that you have a good bite. Your bite is really the foundation for your smile, and that's one of the first things Dr. D is going to look at when he comes in for your exam. Here, for example, is what's considered a normal bite. The jaws are aligned, the teeth aren't too crowded, and the upper front teeth overlap the lower teeth just a little bit. Now, without getting too technical, let's take a look at what are considered bad bites, or what are called malocclusions. Pay attention and see if you think you might fall into one of these categories. A class 2 bite looks like this. You can tell the upper teeth stick out too far ahead of the lower teeth. The opposite of that is a class 3 bite, where as you can see, the lower teeth stick out too far in front of the upper teeth. A crowded bite is just as it sounds. It's when the teeth are just too crowded for the mouth. It's possible you may have what's called a cross bite, and there are actually two kinds of those. This is what's called an anterior cross bite. Notice how as this person bites down, this one upper front tooth actually falls behind some of the lower front teeth. And then there's a posterior cross bite. See how when this person bites down, their top back teeth are inside their lower back teeth? That's not good. That's a posterior cross bite. There are other bite-related issues that Dr. D will be looking for. There's an overbite, which, like it sounds, is a bite where the upper teeth cover too much of the lower teeth. There's overjet, which people sometimes confuse with overbite. Overjet is actually a measure of how far the top teeth are in front of the bottom teeth. See? A normal, healthy overjet is 2 to 3 millimeters, but a problem overjet like this one is more than that. And there's what's called an open bite. Do me a favor and bite down on your back teeth. If your front teeth don't overlap like they should, and there's this open space between top and bottom, then you may very well have an open bite. Dr. D will also be looking for things like a narrow smile, for instance. A narrow smile looks like this, when the upper jaw is just too narrow, and it looks like you have these dark corners on the sides of your mouth. He'll look for signs of what are called digit habits, which is a fancy way of saying thumb sucking or finger sucking. Digit habits are a big but fairly common orthodontic problem. And this is what it leads to. See how narrow the upper arch is and how flared out the upper front teeth are? And he'll also be watching for TMD issues, or problems with your temporomandibular joints, which are basically your jaw joints and the surrounding facial muscles that control your jaws and chewing. TMD problems are caused by things like stress, injury, or grinding or clenching of the teeth. Now that may seem like a lot, but don't worry. While Dr. D will be very thorough in your upcoming exam, it'll still be pretty quick and easy. And once he's done, you'll have a good idea of what your individual situation is, whether or not you need treatment, and if so, what your options are for treatment. Hopefully, all this information will give you a better idea of what to expect in orthodontic treatment. But if you have any other questions, don't worry. Right, Dr. D?
Right, Nikki. You can ask us questions anytime. We want this to be the very best experience you've ever had. I look forward to meeting you, and once again, welcome to Team Orthodontics.